Welcome back to my YouTube channel, everybody. This week, I was constructing again. I find in summer, I'm mad for the construction. So being in the garden more this year, I noticed things that kind of just were unsightly and kind of annoyed me. And the wheelie bins, AKA trash cans. In Ireland, we call it a wheelie bin, a bin on wheels. I guess some people saying, what's a wheelie bin? A bin on wheels. And we've got three for recycling. And they're in the garden, and no matter where I put them, they're just unsightly and just not pretty. So I was like, how can I make them pretty? So I decided to make a wheelie bin cover shield, something to put in front of them to just take that unsightly bin look off them. I am not a carpenter, but I have a shop at construction. I'm getting better, girls, I'm getting better. I'm gonna show you how I made mine, but there are gonna be way better videos on the internet showing you how to make a proper one. But I do hope you get some inspiration from it. Maybe you wanna have a shot at making one, or you're looking for some ideas. So I hope you find this video useful. Okay, I'm going to draw what I wanna make. I'm basically doing a box with no back and no top and no bottom. So my front piece will have loads of like little slats. So that'll be like the screen, and I'll have a post, and then the screen bit on the front. Then I'll have a side piece with a post on the back, and then the side screens. And the same thing here, I'll have a post. Yeah, that looks more like it. So basically, I'm doing a box with no back because it's gonna be pushed against the wall. I'm gonna put wheels on the bottom, and there won't be a top on it because the bins are gonna be inside and I wanna be able to reach in and open the bins. And then I have it on wheels so I can pull it away. So I hope that makes a little bit of sense, but obviously as you see me making it, it's gonna make sense. Here is the messy corner in my garden. I've got my wheelie bins, I've got my scrap wood, I've got some junk, some of my niece and nephew's toys. So this area, just a bit of an eyesore. This side is much prettier, and then you look at this side and it's just filthy. So I started by just clearing the whole area, getting rid of all of my scraps and any bits that I didn't need. We just went to the recycle center. I actually was able to chop up some of my scrap wood, and I gave it to my mom because she has a real fire. I picked up two packets of these treated timber panels. I got these in the builder's yard in B&Q. I also picked up two posts. There's no reason why one of them is bigger than the other. It's just because that's all they had left in stock. The first thing I did was measure the two posts to size. If you want, I can put the measurements for my wheelie bin cover in the description, but it's gonna be unique to yours depending on how big and tall your trash cans are. So I just measured my trash cans, the length, the width, and the depth, before I cut all my pieces of wood to size. I'm just working on the front screen piece of my wheelie bin cover. What I would have done in hindsight is put a middle piece in this, but I didn't have any wood to do a middle piece, but it's not too bad. Once I had all the spaces evenly spaced out, I drilled these in with some deck screws. Once the front piece was done, I started working on the side pieces. I measured them to size and I cut them using my saw. And then I used the front piece as a guide just to lay out my pieces so that they would be evenly spaced, just like the front. I drilled them, and then I had my two side pieces made, and then I just assembled them to the front. You're definitely gonna need two people. I had to kind of lean on the wheelie bin and maneuver. I definitely could have done with a second set of hands when I put them together. I also put the wheels on before I lifted it up because I knew it was going to be hard by myself to put the wheels on last, so I put the wheels on before I lifted it up. Thank you. give you a little just in the garden potter to see what's going. There's one thing I am super proud of. Look at the size of this guy. Like, what? I think he needs to be harvested soon. But I am really impressed with that. There actually is loads of tiny ones. Oh no. Some of my pots fell in the wind. So I noticed that there is little small ones in here. And apparently you can eat these. I think you can fry them and the flowers smell delicious. So I have been a successful courgette farmer. It's like really windy, so I hope my mic isn't going to pick up all the wind, but I've got some little peas and they taste delicious. This is my second batch of peas. The other batch of peas, I harvested them and then they went yellow and died, so I don't know if that's just the life cycle of the pea. Hydrangeas I've managed to keep alive. I realised that these guys need a lot of water, so I've been trying to save buckets of rainwater for them. I've got a purple one here as well. Echinacea, I have been growing this to make tea, so that's done really well and I love that it's high. New favourite plant is, I am loving verbena. I love how tall it is, the bees absolutely love it and it looks really nice. I think it'd look nice in the flower bed. And also my bee buckets. So I noticed this is like cottage bee mix and I just have it in pots and it's just really cheerful. And I've got another book over here. This one looks a bit more wild, but the bees and wildlife are loving it. Like, look at these, so cute. I moved my wheelie bin cover and I moved all of my veg over here so it's in one place. So in here, as you can see, my carrot box planter that I made has worked. Now, I haven't harvested a carrot yet because I'm like, the longer I leave them in there, the bigger it's gonna be. So I'm thinking maybe in 2 weeks time, I'll give a little harvest and I'll see what's in it. And down here, I've got beetroot. Again, I think it needs a little bit more time, but the weather hasn't been great. Maybe it needs some sunshine, I'm not sure. So Blondie's down the end, but this is where I moved my bins and my wheelie bin cover, just down the back because I wanted to keep everything around here. Just all my like little pots and garden and stuff. So my mini garden, this is just some toys from my niece and nephew that I just have just in my garden for them when they come over. So they've got something to play with. My outdoor pub that I built has become a bit of a potting table and a green greenhouse. I have some fennel seeds, but I think their roots got bound because I didn't transplant them quick enough. But I'll see if they do something. These were all planted from seed as well. They're just some herbs. And then I've got more herbs on the wall. I feel like my chamomile needs a bigger pot and probably needs to be put into a bed and not a pot, but I'm gonna harvest some and try and turn it into some tea.
So that's what I constructed this week in the garden. I think it's gonna be nice. You could possibly do something with plants on it, you could do some hanging pots, but I'm kind of reluctant to plant certain things because August, we're kind of coming into that autumn season, so I think I'm just going to leave it as is. But definitely next year I could put some hanging like terracotta pots on it. I could make it look cute. You'll also see in my garden update that I moved it to the end of the garden and it seems to be working. I just didn't like it, seemed a bit clunky, and I had like my carrot box and random things dotted around the garden. So I tidied everything up and I brought my carrot box over to the window, and the garden feng shui just seems a bit better and everything kind of seems to be a bit tidier. I keep my bins out the back and then I have a side entrance, so it's easy for me to just pull them out, wheel them out, and I only have to do it once a week. But I know some people keep their wheelie bins maybe in the front of their house because they might be terraced and you might have your bins in your front garden, and I think this would be a nice idea to do, just to take the kind of look off them and actually make your bins a feature. Nothing wrong with the bins, we all have them, but you could possibly do something to make a feature. I have seen people make like living roofs with alpines. I think that's a deadly idea, something I could possibly add on next year to mine. So yeah, I hope you got a bit of info from it. Also, thumbs up from a giant courgette. I haven't harvested it yet. I'm actually gonna go on Google now and Google when I should harvest it and what I'm gonna make with it. A lot of people were saying just put it on a griddle pan, chop it in half, bit of oil, just fry it, massive. So I don't know, I could make soup. I don't know, my listeners, my ideas are endless. Also, I just realized in America, you guys call a courgette a zucchini. And there's something else. I think cilantro is parsley as well. I've learned a lot this year when it comes to growing things in the garden. I'm definitely not a pro, but I have ideas now for next year. I think this year I just got excited with growing vegetables and I just grew whatever seeds I could get my hands on. But next year, I have the garden Pinterest board going. I'm like, no, I got a plan. There's lots of stuff I didn't grow this year that I'd love to have a shot at growing next year. So I've learned a lot. Transplanting, I suppose, was the big one. And now I'm learning about harvesting. So yeah, I'm gonna harvest that giant courgette. So that is me for this week. Thumbs up if you, cheeky thumbs up, if you enjoyed this video. And I'll see you all in next week's video.